Hey friends, hope you're well. Apple's iOS 18.2 just dropped and there's a big round of changes, new features, and improvements to not only Apple Intelligence, but also iOS altogether. I've been playing around with the beta version for a week, and so in this video, I'll go over everything worth checking out and setting up once you update your iPhone to iOS 18.2. One of the biggest and most useful changes in iOS 18.2 is ChatGPT integration into Apple Intelligence. You'll definitely want to set this up, so go into Settings and then scroll down to Apple Intelligence and Siri, then scroll down again to this new section under Extensions, ChatGPT, and then enable ChatGPT. So you actually don't need a ChatGPT account to use this feature. And in fact, you get access to ChatGPT's advanced features, which essentially queries ChatGPT's latest version, GPT-4o. I believe you only get a small handful of GPT-4o queries until it needs to be reset every 24 hours, as you can see here under daily limit. And then if you have a ChatGPT Plus account already, you'll definitely want to log in for unlimited GPT-4o queries. You even get a limited number of DALL-E 3 image generations too. So I've also manually toggled on confirm GPT request so it doesn't need my permission every time Siri pings GPT. So once it's on, you'll now get more intelligent conversations, insights, and image generation through Siri. So for example, holding down the side button, I can ask it to generate a short apology letter to my principal about my dog eating my homework. So just tap use ChatGPT. And as you can see, it provides a perfectly usable template to send to your principal. And with GPT integration into Siri, it's also now more conversational than ever too. So I can ask follow-up questions, for example, if it doesn't if it's not reading my voice already, I can ask it to make this slightly longer and address it to Karen. And immediately it addresses it to Karen and it is a slightly longer response. So I think it does a far better job than Siri alone ever could, that's for sure. The second feature worth setting up and testing is visual intelligence. And this feature uses ChatGPT's image recognition with text processing to do some cool stuff on your camera app. So I'm going to have to switch over to the iPhone 16 for this feature since it requires the action button for whatever reason, but I'll show you what this looks like. So using the iPhone 16 or the 16 Pro, you'll hold down the action button and this will bring out visual intelligence. So let's bring in this random book here and we'll use visual intelligence to analyze this. So clicking search, you can immediately see that it searches Google and brings up the right results. The other more useful feature, I think, is the ask feature. So I'll show you how this works. Give me a quick summary of this book. And very quickly, there you go. We've got a quick summary of this book. And I found this to be pretty useful, but you might have also noticed that it uses Google. So it's basically Google Lens, but with a dedicated physical button. So back to the iPhone 15, next is the updated writing tools feature. So I've been using this feature from time to time since iOS 18.1 to mainly sort of rewrite emails or rephrase thoughts and notes. But now there is a new option to describe your change so we can completely customize how Apple Intelligence rewords stuff. So bringing up the writing tools option here, you can see this describe your change function. So let's have some fun with it. And let's change this happy birthday block of text. And let's say we want to, you know, change it to a haiku poem. Very, you know, sort of niche, but it will do exactly that in a second. So there we go. It changes it into a haiku poem and, you know, that's pretty hilarious. It's pretty useful if you want to serenade your partner though. So next, there is now a nifty feature to help quickly blur faces in photos. So just bring up a photo. As you see, you might recognize some faces in here. But to do this, all you're going to do is click the Adjustments tab here and then click Cleanup from the iOS 18.1 update. Now, if you sort of just scrub the face of the person that you're trying to blur out, just like this, It will immediately scrub the face, and a safety filter will apply and blur out the face. It's a pretty useful inbuilt tool, and if you're sending a photo and need to protect the identity of a stranger, for example, this is a great option. There's been apps, obviously, that have been able to do this for a while now, but it's just sort of nice to have this baked into iOS. The next one is a fun one, and it's custom emojis, or what Apple calls Genmojis, assuming it's a hybrid word for generative and emojis or something. But yeah, anyway, let's create some custom emojis. So bring up the emoji board here. There is a new button right here. Tap that. And then what you're going to do is simply just describe the emoji that you want to create. So for example, let's have some fun and let's say, you know, dog on a surfboard. And it will generate a bunch of options for you to pick from. So that's quite an odd looking dog, but that's a pretty decent one right there. So from what I've seen, it does a pretty good job basically creating all sorts of emojis to suit any conversation topic, and it's just a load of fun. Another new fun generative feature added to iOS 18.2 is Image Playground. So once you update, you'll find a new app icon here called Playground. So tap into that. So it works like most generative AI programs. Insert a description like puppy in a festive home. I can't type at the moment. Okay, second try. There we go. Let's put this through. And I think the quality of the images have been really impressive so far. It'll give you multiple options yet again. And on top of that, you can easily add to the image by adding more inputs, like let's just type in snow. Make it a bit more festive, have some fun with it. You can also add different illustration styles. So let's change it to illustration, for example. I personally prefer animation, but those are the two options that we currently get. And you can even go ahead actually and add an existing photo like myself into it. And what you get is pretty wild. What is that? Why am I in a suit? But that's not bad. So yeah, it's just a lot of fun. And unlike something like Midjourney, all the processing happens locally on the iPhone with no data sent to the cloud. So you can rest easy using your own photos. Overall, I haven't used it all that much, but it is fun and just nice to have generative AI natively built into iOS. Next up is a new share item location feature. And this one is going to be properly useful if you travel a lot. So it's pretty simple. Go into the Find My app and then tap into the item that you're tracking and then scroll down to share item location. This is a new feature. And basically what this is going to do is this will generate a secure link with the location of the AirTag so you can share with a friend to track the item live or even share it with an airline privately if you've lost your luggage, for example. This is an easy way for an airline to track it down. In iOS 18.2, you can now finally set up default apps and not be restricted to just Apple's native apps. So to do this, go into settings and scroll all the way down to apps. And then at the top, there is a new button here called default apps. Tap into that. And so from here, you can set all sorts of default apps from, you know, Gmail to the browser app. And there's just a lot more convenience here. It's all in one spot. So if you say, you know, use Google Voice app or you use Brave browser more than Safari, you have the option to set these as the default apps right here. You can also now set up a core filtering system through specific apps. So iOS, I think, is finally catching up to Android in these features, but just really slowly. Now going back out to the apps page and finding Safari here, there is also a new function here called Safari Not Secure Warning. And this is a new setting worth toggling on. So you want to scroll all the way down to the privacy and security area right here. And there's a new toggle, Not Secure Connection Warning. I recommend turning this on. So the label name is a bit confusing, but I recommend turning this on because it only allows Safari to browse to sites that have SSL or TLS enabled for security reasons. By default, you can visit HTTP only sites, but enabling this option will block that attempt to view a HTTP site. And if you hit that site, it'll look something like this. Now, here is a couple of new volume related settings that are worth checking out. The first one is under sound and haptics. And if you scroll to the bottom, you'll find that there is new volume limits built in speaker option here. So turning this on will allow you to set the volume to a custom percentage, and it's a useful setting to customize if you want to avoid loud media playback or you just want to preserve battery by capping your iPhone's volume output. There's now also an option to place the volume slider back onto the home screen rather than the side. So going into settings and then accessibility, scroll down to, where did it go? Audio and visual. So from here, you want to go down to always show volume control, so turn that on. So now turning this on and going to the home screen, you can see the volume slider is now on the home screen rather than the side, and it's always showing there. I find this so much more useful, and I'm glad to see this making a comeback. So yeah, overall, Apple iOS 18.2 is a significant step up, and the iOS ecosystem should look even better with future updates like battery intelligence features, Siri's on-screen awareness, and things like that, which I believe are coming soon. Be sure to subscribe if you want to see those updates in the future, and if you made it to the very end of this video, drop the code word comment GPT, and I'll give it a like. I'll drop a video here to some of my favorite free iPhone apps if you'd like to check that out. And as always, thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.